Go ahead.
I don't know where to begin. First of all, I'd like to say I didn't even know anything about this hearing.
You were here last month.
I was, but I wasn't, I didn't know what the results were going to be, and...
The results were that no one was to be living in the building, and that we were going to come back and action would be taken if something wasn't done to...
Okay, well, I don't live in the building. I never lived in the building. I'm there a lot. I'm still there a lot. Everything is there, like piano, computers, a telephone, everything. And I use that, and I'm using the property for doing internet television. And
okay. Does the board have any questions? Do you want to respond?
Yes.
Okay.
I just asked the board, legally, my client has a lease with this gentleman, and depending on the outcome of this, we'll take the appropriate action. I can inform that we have given various notices, such as 3 days, 15 days in the past. You know, and I would ask that the board abate any fine, if there was to be a fine, until we can let the legal process, so it doesn't put my clients in legal jeopardy with this gentleman, because we do have a lease agreement with him.
You have a lease agreement with him, and you have filed with the proper authority to evict? You said you had a 3 day and a 15 day?
There's proper notice that must be delivered to the tenant.
Correct.
Just like these hearings, you have to give proper notice. There's due process procedures that
Correct.
Have to take place before it even gets into the court system. We've done that in the past. We've done that based on the board's last hearing. And pending the outcome of this, will dictate whether we're successful or not. I believe, you know, it's going to end up in the court system. So I'd ask that whatever potential fine be abated until we allow that procedure or proceeding.
Have you filed a 3 day notice?
He's paid the rent.
He's paid the rent. Have you filed then what have you filed with the county?
There's nothing you have to file with the county.
For eviction.
All notices go to the tenant and himself.
I guess the question is, have you already filed anything before?
Right.
No. Because we have to file the 3 day and 15 day notices, all have to go to the tenant. None of that is through the court process.
At first.
Once those time periods expire, then of course it.
How far along are you in the procedure?
The 15 day notice has been delivered.
When was that delivered?
He would be, the expiration of the 15 days would either be today or tomorrow.
Okay.
Can I ask you?
All right, board questions, please.
Could you let us know what are the limitations on his lease to the use of the property? What does it say that he's renting this property for?
And look, that's going to be relevant in this situation. Our question here is, what we're going to be alleged is that the property is a commercial structure approved for commercial use, and that was being used for residential use that he was living in. The prior testimony and the previous proceeding was that there was an event, a police event that brought law enforcement out, domestic event where there were allegations made that they were living there. Since the proceeding, our inspector went out there. The pictures show, and his testimony is that he found the condition of someone living there. There were futons, kitchenettes, there were things that was consistent with someone living on the property. And at this point, what we're left with is he's hadn't done anything that's satisfied that he's not living there. He hasn't made any alterations from residential appearance to commercial appearance. And the position of the staff is that he's still not compliant. And I understand the request of Mr. Hall. And you know, quite honestly, and, you know, historically, if someone is in deep diligence trying to pursue means such as court means or whatever, then that's something for taking consideration on RV one or another, because I know historically we have. I think what your questions were is having the ability to pursue and taking the legal actions to address it.
My question, Rich, which I'd like to finish now, is does your lease forbid him from having living quarters in that property?
Yes.
All right, that's all I wanted to know.
Okay, go ahead, Mrs. Hines.
I have a question also. Not only him, doesn't our city code forbid that? Okay.
And yes, the answer is yes.
Okay, and if I can remember correctly, last month, we were supposed to code.
Well, I mean, here's the situation. Is
let me clarify this. It's a fine is an in-rim action against the property, not against the tenant. I think we need to give the tenant the landlord opportunity to evict him. If he doesn't, then I think we need to because that may solve the problem. He's evicted, that solves the problem. If he doesn't, then I think at that point we have to think about some fines. But
I certainly agree with that.
Excuse me, sir. You're not testifying right now.
We would hold in our action up until we would have to their situation. If he gets evicted, then that takes care of the problem.
And that we would agree with that. We don't have a problem if the board comes back and says not compliant. Our problem is if you start fining us until we've had the opportunity to legally.
How long will that take you foresee?
I would hope within 30 days.
Okay.
At least they can start with the legal process.
The legal process can start within 30 days. Yes.
My next question is, did I not hear you say that when you gave the first notice of something, you said he paid the rent. So what
correct.
I'm asking now is, if he paid the rent now, would
it's a different
issue.
No, it's a different issue. The 15 and the 3 day are two separate issues. The 3 day is, you know, they might have to pay rent. And,
right.
And every time he's been given a 3 day or that time period comes up, he pays the rent. So it avoids that issue. But I can assure the board that as soon as these issues originally arose, my clients retained me specifically to avoid this matter. They don't want to be fined. They've own those properties for quite some time. They own additional properties on Blue Road. I've dealt specifically with Mr. Jackson and the officer doing what we can legally. So I'm just asking that the board hold off on any fines until we have the opportunity to legally remove him as the tenant.
All right, are there any other comments from the board? I just want to make sure that progress is being made in evicting the tenant, the so-called tenant.
That's progress being made by then.
Right.
And they would say one way or the other, we're in the middle of that.
Right, we are not. All right, the chair will entertain a motion to amend the previous order of noncompliance and allow respondent until December 3rd, the next cutoff date, to come in to compliance and we return to a subsequent meeting for consideration of a fine of up to $100 a day.
$1,000
a day. Right. Is there such a motion? So moved by Mrs. Hines, a second.
Mr. Jones.
All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Like sign opposed. And right, motion carries.
Now, if I can ask one more thing, the tenant has indicated, at least when we testified that she has an alternative address where he actually resides. And what we really want to do is just be able to resolve this case. If indeed there is an alternative place, our folks go to it and we can show that and show that this is not any other place.
Yes.
What we would like her to know is exactly exactly
that's between you and him.
Yeah.
Tony, if you think that's there's a situation to create a problem, that's fine. But right now the issue is between these two. And if you can get to find a way to resolve, that's fine.
Well, I'm just saying from perspective, and this is the perspective of staff, this is and being sworn in on the oath, being driven.
That's fine.
Okay.
like to follow up on that.
It's 227 Madison Apartment.
I don't know how that will affect.
That's nothing.
Okay, that's got nothing to do with us.
I wonder if you're down to keep Chris Jackson a little bit, the eviction process and what's going on.
Exactly, that's what I'm most interested in.
It takes longer than 30 days, they'll work with you, but I just.
Right.
I'll keep Mr. Jackson in the loop.
Good.
I'll get in touch with his office.
Okay, so that's fine.
That date, one more time, is December 5th?
December 3rd.
December 3rd, sorry.
Next cutoff date.
Mm-hmm. And the meeting date will be December 11th. I'll email you.
Okay, thank you.
All right, thank you so much.
Are you serious? Thank you.
Yes. No, the case is over.
I have a completely different picture.
I'm sorry.
You're not listening, you're not gonna hear my.
We have determined.
Taking action, and action works.
We have finished with this case.
You don't wanna hear what I have to tell you?
The case.
You don't have, you wanna hear how you've been lying through so far?
No, not now.
Gentlemen.
No.
You don't wanna hear that?
I want.
You have been lying.
I want you to please step away from the microphone.
Several lies. Just wanted to know that. Hey, I have a lot invested in.
I would like you to step away from the microphone, please, this case is over.
Thank you.
Okay, all right, now, I'll go back to case number one. And that is case number CEB 10-14-108, James Ashburn and Ace Cash Express.
You have to take this up.
Let me explain it to you so you know what's going on.
How does he speak for himself?
I mean, I'm getting through, that's what.
No, you're not. Let's listen.
Okay.
The code inspector just has to prove that you're not living there.
Okay.
So what he'll do is in the next couple of weeks, because the next hearing's in 30 days, he'll go to your Madison Avenue address just to make sure that you're there, and then it'll be done.
Okay.
Now, if the owner of the property wants to evict you, that's nothing to do with code. But I think that once their case is closed, the property owner will be done with it. They won't evict you, they won't do anything. We just have to prove that you don't live there.
And that would close the case?
Yes, sir.
But they have other zoning issues too. They're gonna come up with something else, I'm sure, as soon as they get that.
No, it's just the fact you can't live there.
Yes.
And once we are shown that you do not live there, then it's closed. That's all it is. And once the case is closed, the property owner will be done with it.
And is that the black gentleman that's both?
No, the black gentleman is the attorney for the city.
Yes.
He doesn't have anything to do with us.
He spoke that.
Yes.
I know he said something, he said that there was an alternative address. He's not the one to talk to?
No, the white, Mr. Fitzgerald.
The fellow next to him?
Not the Hispanic guy, the white guy, the chunky-ish guy.
That was standing next to him with the microphone.
Yes, he will be the one to come out to make sure that you live on Madison, and then the case is closed.
And then that could be satisfy the landlord, which would free them.
Yes, and we just have to do it within these next 30 days, and then it's all done.
I mean, I have my rent receipt right here.
That'd be perfect.
And I wish they would've asked me about that, I could've shown them that.
Well, you know what, they, the board, the panel, they don't have time for all that.
Yeah.
So, get with Mr. Fitzgerald, and do you have his phone number?
Yes, I do.
Okay, and make a copy of your rental agreement for Madison Avenue, and give that to him, and you can close your case.
Okay.
Make sure it's done within 30 days.
Yeah, okay.
Okay, that's all you have to do.
Thank you, officer.
All right, no problem.
Appreciate you talking with us.
No problem.
Thank you very much.
Have a good day.
Really, thank you very much.
You're welcome, no problem.
Have a good day.
You too.
Yeah, go on, I'm around back.
Gee, I felt frustrated.
I know.
They won't let me talk.
Thank God she came out and spoke with you.
Huh?
I say, thank God that officer came out and explained it.
I think, I,